In Acts chapter 12, persecution increases for the church. In fact, Herod, it says, begins to come against the church in a powerful way. Listen to what happens. Now, about that time, Herod the king stretched out his hand to harass some of the church. He killed James, the brother of John, with the sword. And because he saw it pleased the Jews, he proceeded further to seize Peter also, and it was during the days of unleavened bread. This story, well, first of all, it's the first time we hear of any of the apostles losing their lives. In fact, there's no other place in history that we really know of or in the Bible that tells how one of the apostles really died. James, the brother of John, the first to have his head cut off by Herod with a sword. And then Peter is arrested. These are major leaders in the church, so persecution is getting very close to home. Now, if you know the story, it's powerful. Peter's there in prison, and the church is praying. An earthquake occurs, and Peter is set free. Now, that's amazing. But you also want to stop and say, well, what about James? James was also in prison. No earthquake, no being set free. You wonder, God, why? Why James and not Peter? Or why not Peter and let James go free? We don't know those answers. We can't understand why some people go to heaven early and some stay here. But we do know this, that they both love the Lord, they both serve the Lord, and that God is in charge. James becomes a martyr. He is forever brought into the presence of the Lord. Peter stays on earth, and God uses him all through the book of Acts in a powerful way. God is sovereign, but we know this. He loved Peter just as much as he loved James, and we trust him with both of their lives.